Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to another edition of SmackDown. This is Michael Cole here with my broadcast partner, Taz at Ringside. And Taz, how'd you like to be in this man's shoes tonight?
I can't believe it's even ended yet, Cole. If you're willing to be the special referee in a match between Benoit and Taker, you're either stupid or crazy. And here I was thinking Kevin Long actually liked this guy. I don't envy him one bit.
Yeah. KKK.
Blair, I don't know what the heck you were thinking last week, but you landed yourself in a whole lot of hot water. All I asked you to do was to call that match right down the middle. But I guess the Undertaker didn't see it that way. Anyway, you've got the dead man mad at you. And that's like signing your own death warrant. He's asked for a match against you. And there ain't no way I'm gonna tell that man no. But here's the really scary part. No one's seen Benoit since last week's match. And I've got no idea what's going through Benoit's head. Good luck, player. You're gonna need it.
Rolling down.
We know that music. Here comes The Undertaker. Under normal circumstances, he'd be considered the most intimidating superstar on SmackDown. But I'd say he's in a particularly foul mood tonight after the controversial match he had with Chris Benoit last week.
Come on, Cole. Have you ever seen The Undertaker in a good mood? Besides, I can understand why Taker is angry. Thanks to the ref, the match didn't solve nothing between the dead man and the rabid Wolverine.
You know, I thought I felt sorry for this man last week when he had to referee one of the Undertaker's matches. But now he's got the competing one.
Well, that's what happens when you try to play favorites as a special referee.
Frankly, I'm not even sure that he played favorites, Pat. This could all be some sort of misunderstanding. But nevertheless, I guess we all understand now why no one else wanted to referee that match last week.
Big train rolling down the line makes me lonely. Sometimes I
Thanks, man.
What? I didn't sabotage your match. You don't believe me? Fine. You don't scare me, dead man. Come on!
Out of my way, Junior. I want a rematch, Taker, without your flunky here.
What? Bring it!
Is that right?
I want my title match, Taker. Just you and me, so leave your little punk out.
Hey, what the hell?
Get your damn hands off me. You are mine, dead man. I'm sick of you ducking me, Undertaker. You know I'm the most dominant superstar in SmackDown, and you know you can't prove me wrong!
You think I'm afraid of you, little man? I can't count the number of superstars who have tested themselves against the dead man and come up short. If you insist on making this mistake, then your grieving family will have no one to blame but you when the inevitable occurs.
You know it's the Mac Militant!
Coming to get it on.
Here comes SmackDown General Manager Teddy Long.
Let me holler at you, players. Now, you've obviously got some unfinished business with each other, and I respect that. But I also respect that there's a third superstar involved in this who would not have been involved if I didn't make him the special referee for your match 2 weeks ago. So tonight, for our main event, I'm giving him the chance to prove himself against you, Benoit, one-on-one. And I've got some big plans for No Mercy that involve the three of you. Holla, holla, holla.
What is T-Lo talking about?
I have no idea, partner. But if I know our general manager, they're going to be huge.
California, weighing 165 pounds, Rey Mysterio!
Just keep my heart beating in your seat.
What do you want, Taker?
Save your hostility for the ring, Benoit. I came to tell you that I look forward to laying our differences to rest at No Mercy.
Aren't you forgetting about somebody?
He is a distraction. This began between the two of us, and by all rights, it should end between the two of us.
I hope you're not suggesting that we form some kind of alliance. Because I don't care which one of you I have to force to tap out tonight.
I'm not suggesting anything of the kind. I've said all I came to say. Actually, there is one more thing. I hope you have no illusions that you will make me submit tonight.
Here comes Chris Benoit. Taz the Rabid Wolverine looks even more intense and focused than usual for tonight's triple threat match.
Of course he does, Cole. There's a lot at stake here tonight. A lot of pride on the line.
Benoit must avoid losing to one of his opponents tonight in order to continue to No Mercy. And if he wins, he gets to choose the No Mercy match type. You've got to think that a triple threat match like this would favor a superstar like The Undertaker, Taz. It's hard enough to garner a victory over The Undertaker in the best of circumstances.
Maybe, maybe not. I know the other two guys in this match don't see eye to eye. But if they decide to team up against him, it could be bad news for the dead man.
What you gonna do when we come for you? Talk about your rotten luck. It was in order for Teddy Long to put this man in the middle of the rivalry between Benoit and The Undertaker. And he's been paying for it ever since.
You see it as a bad thing, but I see it as a good thing. Let's face it. Even if he loses here tonight, an impressive showing against superstars like Benoit and The Undertaker counts for something. You know what I mean?
Position for all to see. We're trying to miss the power.
three.
Chris Benoit has a great deal of confidence in his abilities, but I've never got the sense that he's got a swell head pass.
Absolutely not. This thing that they had going with The Undertaker, it wasn't about talking cred. It was about getting the respect he deserves for the career he's had.
And tonight at No Mercy could be another one of the many high points in the career of Chris Benoit. Take anything away from his past, but I don't think many people expected him to make it to No Mercy.
I gotta agree with you. Again, nothing against the guy, but he went up against two of the greatest superstars in the history of the business. I gotta say, I'm impressed.
Sometimes we have to ride away. Up the sky makes me wonder.
job. Niggas get past me. I've been doing this before. I dropped the nasty. For that, now stick them up. 10-4, good buddy. Tone got his money up. Worth swinging, still back your bitch. Looking, staring at the angel with death. Lying, lying, pants on fire. You burning up like David Koresh. This is architect music.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to SmackDown. Along with Taz, I'm Michael Cole and Parker. We're just weeks away from the Thanksgiving Tradition Survivor Series. And here comes the man who thinks that he should be the number one contender for Chris Benoit's World Heavyweight title at Survivor Series, Johnny Nitro.
And hey, why not? The guy's going straight to the gold. Taking gold, at least. He's young and he's hungry. And he's got something to prove here tonight in this match.
Contender fans are clamoring for Taz. There's no question why SmackDown General Manager Theodore Long named this man Benoit's opponent at Survivor Series. You asked me.
Nobody asked me anything, Cole, so you kind of should shut up. But anyway, I do have to win you this time. He's at the top of the heap for sure, whether Johnny Mantle wants him in or not. And this is his chance to silence his critics, including Mantle, right here tonight.
Admit that you really showed me something out here today. And maybe you do deserve to be the number one contender. But dude, we've seriously got to work on that image. And that's where I come in.
Oh, please!
Look, you're a pretty tough guy, but you've got all the personality of a block of wood. I mean, seriously. You're all steak, no sizzle. Stick with me. I'll teach you how to break necks in the ring and give the women whiplash on Hollywood Boulevard. I'll make you a star, because you're good for business. And what's good for business is good for all of us.
Did you just hear that? Johnny Nitro says he's gonna help mold him into a true world heavyweight champion.
You don't seriously think that Nitro's onto something here, do you? Aren't you supposed to be Mr. It's What You Do in the Ring That Matters?
Hey, champ. I hear you're locking up
with Benoit in a non-title match tonight. Try not to let him land too many face shots, because I know this guy who's going to do a photo shoot for us tomorrow is a favor, all right? Oh, and just in case Benoit is more trouble than you can handle, I want you to know that I got your back, pal. All right, see you out there.
Contest is scheduled for one fall. On the winning ring, from San Diego, California, weighing 165 pounds, Rey Mysterio.
Nitro doing out here? This isn't his match.
He's watching his buddy's back, Cole, just like he said he would.
My God, the speed of Chris Benoit!
There it is, Cole. Benoit's got a crossface locked in. He's tapping.
Benoit's not letting up, and Johnny Nitro can't get in the ring to stop it.
Hey, come on now. Cut Nitro some slack, Cole. He just tried to help his buddy, and it backfired in a big way.
Rolling down. Sometimes I wake up.
I think it was pretty cool of Nitro to team up against Benoit. Nitro is a tag team specialist and a multi-time former tag team champion. And just about the best guy you can ask to watch your back as your partner.
I don't know about that, Taz. There's no disputing Johnny Nitro's tag team credentials, but he seems to have a problem with biting off more than he can chew.
What you gonna do when we come for you?
He looks like he's recovered, but is he actually at 100% here tonight?
How many times do I have to say, Cole? That was all just an accident. Nitro's gonna have his back tonight. Just you wait and see, that girl, bitch.
Great.
Nitro's going for Benoit.
Looks like Batista's not having any of that.
I think he's trying to tell Benoit that he wasn't in on it.
There ain't no reasoning with the Rabbit Wolverine, Cole. Not in that ring.
He's got him locked in the crossface. Who needs enemies?
You gotta give Johnny Nitro credit. He's doing his best to help out his pal. Even
and it's going to come to a head this Sunday.
Whoa, wait a minute. What's Nitro doing?
Johnny Nitro's got the title belt.
Here comes Cole. I told you Nitro was going to make an impact.
Nitro hit Chris Benoit. Nitro hit the champion. I don't believe it.
I told you, Cole. I told you.
I can't believe it. Nitro actually was trying to help the contender all along. It was Chris Benoit he was trying to sabotage all this time.
Sure showed Chris Benoit who's boss last Friday night on SmackDown, huh? If you do that at Survivor Series, you're the new World Heavyweight Champion. I wish I could be there to watch your back, but for some reason, Teddy Long says he's banning me from the arena. Anyway, give me a call back so we can discuss some strategy, okay? I've got a great plan that'll make the last few weeks look like child's play. Later. Hey dude, it's Nitro again. I haven't heard back from you, so maybe you didn't get the last message or something. Listen, you've got to call me back so we can discuss your title match. I've put way too much time and energy into this thing for it to fall apart now. Plus, I've got three magazines fighting for the exclusive cover story about your championship. I'll have my cell phone on all day, except for my 5 o'clock teeth whitening treatment, of course. Hey, you know, you should really consider that. I know this guy who... Well, anyway, give me a call. We'll do lunch. Hey, Mr. Big Shot. I don't know what your problem is, but I left you two messages and you didn't call me back. Maybe now that you put Chris Benoit on the crossface, you think you're too good to talk to... Hold on a sec. Oh, hey there, Chris. What's up, champ? Wait, hold on, Benoit. No, don't...
Too bad you couldn't see your little pal here tap out just now. But I'll be seeing you tap tonight. Two-step, that go. The Marcel.